Hi, scientist. I've been back in the science studio working on my furry bear sculpture. What do you think? It looks a lot fuzzier now with the furry texture I've added, doesn't it? Now it's time to move on to the turtle. Do you think a furry texture would work well on this animal? No, I don't think so either. Turtles are covered in something different than bears are. Their bodies are covered in something much harder and smoother than fur. They have scales. But how do animals move if they are covered in something so hard? And why do they have scales instead of fur? Let's head back to the zoo to answer these questions and get a closer look at animals with scales. Here we are, back in the zoo. I think I know just where to start to see some scales in action. There it is, the crocodile we saw last time. Do you see how those hard, flat plates cover its body? Those are its scales. Scales can look a little different on different kinds of animals. They can be smooth or bumpy, big or small, and all kinds of colors. The scales on the crocodile's back are very hard, bumpy, and even sharp in some places. And the scales are all different sizes all over its body. Wow, these scales look tough and strong, like armor. Do you think they protect animals the way fur does? I think they're even stronger than fur. That hardness protects them from sharp things outside, bites from other animals, and keeps water from soaking into their bodies. If you have your science sketchbook on hand, pause the video and draw the crocodile scales. Take your time, then we'll move on to the next animal. Ooh, do you see that snake in the tree now? I almost missed that. The way it hides its green body in the tree leaves reminds me of how the polar bear blended into the snow around it. Scales must help animals camouflage too. The furry animals we saw had long, strong legs to help them move around. But these scaly animals have short legs or none at all. How do you think animals with scales move around? Doesn't all that armor weigh them down? Look, there it goes. Do you see the scales move with the snake's body? Its small, softer scales help the snake grip the tree branch and move its body around. Huh. I always thought snakes were slimy. Looking at this one, the scales are really just shiny. Take a minute now to draw the snake scales in your science sketchbook. Then, we'll look at another scaly animal when you're ready. Here they are. Fish. Fish scales overlap each other, like roof shingles or the layers of a pine cone. This pattern and their smooth and slippery texture helps them glide through the water. I wonder if they're cold swimming in there all the time. And at the water's surface is just the scaly friend I was looking for, a turtle. What do you notice about its scales? Are they big, small, hard, or soft? Or a little bit of everything? I notice it has big scales on its back and smaller scales on the rest of its body. Do you think the big scales on its shell are different from the smaller ones on its legs? Yeah, the shell scales look a lot harder and tougher, like a big shield for its body. And the smaller scales are on the parts of the turtle that move around a lot. This close-up is a good chance to draw those scales in your science sketchbook. Pause the video here so you can draw those now. seems like these guys love to soak up the sun. But I wonder, don't they get too hot sitting in the sun all day? Between these turtles in the hot sun and those fish in the cold water, there must be something about scales that helps animals keep their bodies at just the right temperature. Ah, Mia says they do. The scales protect animals from extreme temperatures. They stay cool and full of water in hot, dry places and soak up heat from the sun when they're cold. Wow, scales have some pretty amazing protections for animals. I'm excited to add some to my turtle when we get back to the science studio. Whoa, did you see that? It was covered in something that looks like fur and scales at the same time. And so many colors. I can't wait to discover what's covering that animal next. Thanks for exploring with me today. Until then, keep creating, and I'll see you back in the science studio and beyond. Hey, hey.